Happy hump day. I hope that my title slash thumbnail did not offend anybody. I do not mean that it is all about me. I mean that today the tip is all about me. Me, right? Me? No, not me. Me. Let me explain. So, tip number five, December 5th, tip number five is make some time for me, for you. Take some me time. So, Christmas shopping, Christmas traffic, Christmas children and Santa and everything is a lot. It is very hectic. It is stressful for a lot of people. And sometimes we can get caught up in trying to get all of our stuff done for everybody else that we forget to take time for ourselves to just sit back and relax and enjoy the reason for the season, or just to enjoy the season in general. So, some tips for taking some me time would be enjoy a cup of coffee. Wake up a little extra early so you can enjoy that alone, preferably. I prefer it because it's nice and quiet. Or go to Starbucks or one of your local coffee shops and just kind of take some time away from everything. Indulge in a hobby that you like to do that you might not always have a lot of time for. Maybe you like to color or crochet or knit. I say crochet because I crochet. Or read. Maybe you're into a good book. Just take some time. I know it might not seem like you have it, but give yourself an hour, maybe even 20 minutes. 20 minutes to an hour if you have the time to just put everything else that you have to do aside. It's only the 5th. We have 20 days until Christmas, so we have plenty of time to get everything done. And just give yourself some time and just chill out. Chill out. Relax. Enjoy it. Don't be a Scrooge, okay? And this, taking this tip to heart, can ensure that you won't become a Scrooge. If you want to listen to Christmas music while you do so, I would encourage that because I am a big fan. If you want to take a break from that, though, and listen to something else, that's cool, too. Just do whatever it is that helps you relax, helps you kind of zone in to your happy place, I guess. And then just take a few minutes to an hour, like I said, and just really indulge in that. You deserve it. You're working hard out there. Maybe you're working hard. Maybe you're working hard getting gifts and being a little, you know, helping Santa get everything done. But it's well worth it, and it will help you keep up a good attitude and keep you from getting stressed and kind of bogged down with everything. And also it's just healthy to do that. But I think it's very important to take some time for me and for you to take some time for you because, especially in Christmas time, it's about love and family all around. So that doesn't necessarily mean like sacrifice your happiness to make others happy, right? You can sacrifice some things, you know, to help maybe sacrifice your time to give them a good gift or sacrifice, I don't know, maybe don't buy yourself a cup of coffee so you can afford this other nice thing that you want. A lot of my examples include coffee, but it's kind of the thing that's always on my mind, so be it. But sacrificing your happiness is not something you should do, ever, really, but especially during Christmas, because we want to tap into that excitement and anticipation and magic and just enjoy the excitement, right? I think it's actually, don't quote me on this, but I think it's scientifically proven that, like, in your brain, more dopamine levels are released when you're anticipating something than once you actually get whatever it is you're waiting for. So that's why, like, instant gratification is not great because there's not as much excitement and anticipation, right? So if you start enjoying and kind of tapping into that excitement before Christmas, 20 days before, you're going to be really excited about the time you get there. So that's tip number five today. Take some time for you, some me time. Don't take my picture and title and think that I'm selfish, because I'm not, or I try not to be anyway. But I just thought it was clever. So enjoy your hump day. Take some time for yourself. Relax. We've got 20 days. We're all good. And I'll see you tomorrow for tip number six. Keep it simple.